And now the purple dusk of twilight time steals across the meadows of my heart. High up in the sky, the little stars climb.
Hi, John Solari, your host of The Method Actor Speaks. And today we have a new member of Alcoholics. I'm going to say Alcoholics Anonymous. Are you of the Actors Studio?
No, I'm not an alcoholic. But I am a new Actors Studio member.
Where'd that come from? I can't believe that came from a new member, Cindy. Now you have an Italian name, but you Americanized it, so I want you to pronounce both names.
My name is Cindy Marin Angel, but my great-grandfather came over as Amerigo Mariangeli. So it's missing an eye.
And he couldn't get work, right?
He couldn't get a job at Sears. Sears didn't hire people back in the day with a vowel at the end of their last name. So Marin Angel, here I am.
Oh, great. Well, I'm proud that you're Italian.
Thank you.
Because I always like, well, is there a reason why you didn't go back to using it?
No, I haven't. Honestly, it's just the way it's come through.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Because I always encourage Italians to go back to using their names.
It's been suggested to me. Maybe.
It's such a beautiful name.
Thank you very much. And, Angel of the Sea or Mary's Angels.
See?
I'm in the City of Angels. Where else could I be?
Right. And why did you become an actor?
I have been acting all my life. My first audition was as a baby in New York. My mother said I screamed the whole time. She never took me back. My first leading role was in kindergarten. In the kindergarten through third grade play, I knew everybody's lines, sang, and that's my first memory on stage. Hiding behind a little wooden snow cloud and laughing at the people laughing at me as I peeked out.
Really?
And I just kept, I was always on stage doing theater.
Where in New York did you live?
My parents were actually living in New Jersey. My dad was trying to be a singer.
Oh.
He's got headshots from back in Central Park, back in the 70s.
In my era.
Cut a record, you know.
Really? What was his name?
His name then was Noel Roberts. They changed his name, see? There you go, Dad. Yeah. So they can't blame me for running away and becoming an actor.
That's true.
Yes.
Yeah, they change people's names. I remember when I first started acting, they wanted to change mine to John Lawrence.
Okay.
When on the manhunt, she said, but you don't look Italian. I said, I don't care. I'm Italian. I want my name.
Yes, yes.
And besides, I wanted to be a gangster, not an actor.
Okay.
Really?
Okay.
God, so you grew up in what part of Jersey?
I was born near Hackensack, but I was actually raised outside of Chicago.
Hackensack, I think there's a Solari restaurant there.
Okay.
Really, it's very famous.
Okay.
In Hackensack.
Okay.
And they shot a thing there of the Sopranos there.
Mm.
Oh, my name. So in New York and Jersey and...
Yeah, I didn't spend much time there, just as a baby, and then I was raised outside of Chicago, but I did theater all through there, and then...
What type of theater?
I was always on stage in the school shows. I was a cheerleader. I was a pom-pom girl. I was always in the dance shows. I then started going to Second City just for fun. I had no idea what was going on. My first teacher was Nia Vardalos from my Big Fat Greek Wedding. Yeah, day one.
Yeah.
And actually, when I moved out to L.A., that was the first one-woman show I saw.
We have a reel of yours, so whenever they're ready,
We're
going to play it. I'll just let you guys play whenever you're ready.
Sure.
And we'll just keep talking.
Sure.
And I look like, what's his name? Oh, Madonna mia. I look like, what's his name? The guy that's dead, the Campbell's soup.
Kid?
What was his name? Yeah.
Andy Warhol.
Well, I hang out with Michael J. Pollan. He's the last disciple of Andy.
Sure.
So whenever that thing is ready, we'll go for it.
Sure.
Now, me, on the other hand, I don't mind when a man tries to buy me. Only when he doesn't offer enough.
How much is enough?
Well, if you have to ask.
That a woman should not expect to be taken care of. That this was, in fact, a subtle form of slavery. And conversely, if a woman pursued a man or married him for his paycheck with the expectation of being taken care of, that she was, let us be blunt, nothing more than a prostitute. Without the courage to admit that she was to herself nor the courtesy to inform her only client.
So should I wear the thing with the... Okay, well, what about the one with the... Okay, I'll just leave on this.
Good. What about me? Should I wear the...
No.
Okay, what about the sweater with the...
No.
Or just leave on the thing?
Okay. All right. So, two buttons or three?
Well, it's the difference between I'll call you and I'll wake you. Mm. What about me? Two buttons or three?
Oh, definitely two. It's the difference between I'll call you and I'll sell you an area rug. Mike, there's something I have to tell you.
Yeah.
The date that I have is with
my shrink.
How to make me happy, how to satisfy me.
Obviously, those talents didn't cut it when you left me for another woman.
My lust for Monica had no reflection on you. It was just that. It was lust. We would still be together if you weren't so prudish about my sexual proclivity. Can you hang on a second? I got another call coming in. My husband and I got into a fight. We were fighting so much in the car, he said, you know what? Let me out of this piece of shit. And he gave me his goddamn attitude, you know?
Bag this up, baby!
Now, that just leaves the small matter of the harassment charges and your attorney's fees. We're prepared to offer your client $5,000 to walk away right now with no admission of liability on the part of our clients.
Yeah, we'll take $8 million.
Get serious.
Okay, then, $12 million. I'm only going that low because, you know, we used to have sex a lot back when I worked here.
Don't embarrass yourself. I'm still trying to keep a little bit of respect for you.
Look at me, Sam.
I've been reading Dr. Phil's Relationship Rescue, okay? You are not plugged in to this family. And how's that working for you? Don't you want to tie me up?
Can't we just cuddle for once?
No.
Yeah, we're gonna do it.
We're gonna do it.
That was good.
Thank you.
But Cindy, Tina, his wedding.
Tony and Tina's wedding. Yeah, that was a live on the air news promo.
Really?
Back in the day. Yeah, I got married a whole bunch at Tony and Tina's wedding.
God, I remember that. Aren't they making a movie? No, it's Mamma Mia that they're making a movie about. But everybody, it was like the biggest dinner theater going.
I think it was one of the longest running off-Broadway shows in history. And it's still running in Chicago. I was in the first year. We got to go to Vegas and I played just about every role.
So you were in the original then?
I was not the original. The first year in Chicago. Mm-hmm. But it was in New York first.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. It was exciting. And it was a great learning ground because I had just come out of Second City Conservatory in Chicago, 5 years of improv, and this was an improv show.
Right.
So there were certain, you know, I did it for years and I loved it. It was really an educational training ground for me in Chicago.
Now, how does improv help you with your acting?
Improv, you know, I just thought the classes were cool and fun, and I had no, I wasn't intending to become a professional actress at all at the time, and I had no idea the clout that it held. I just did it for fun, and it's ended up being my saving grace because I'm not nervous. I'm able to put a little button on something here, you know, it just freed me up and let me play.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, when I met you at the studio, you seemed very confident.
Oh, thank you.
You know, when you're sitting there.
Thank you.
Beyond, I didn't realize you were a new member.
Brand new, just got in June.
You know.
One of 11 this year out of 2000.
So. I would have never thought about it.
Now,
what made you come to Actors Studio?
I wanted to find the best place to go to continue studying, and I wanted to be a part of the best. And I thought, I'm just going to try. I can try.
Now, what was your first scene?
The first scene I did was from A Hat Full of Rain.
Oh, that which originated at Actors Studio.
Oh, did it? Mm-hmm.
Did you know that?
No, uh-uh.
It was Mike Gazzo did it.
Okay.
Wrote it.
Okay.
And actually, I did his only other play that he ever wrote was called October Night at Tommy Zero.
Okay.
But what happened at Actors Studio back in the 50s, they put it together. They used to do scenes.
Mm-hmm.
And they won, and Gazzo would sit there and write scenes from what he improv.
Okay.
Anthony Francioso, Shelley Winters, all of them, they created A Hat Full of Rain.
Mm. Well, they asked me to do a different scene with a different partner the next time I came back, and I had done a scene from Proof to get into a different theater company, and so I dusted that off and came in, and that got me to the finals, and then got me accepted. So.
What I'm curious about now, how do you work? Now, you played the wife, you know, in Hat Full of Rain. Now this takes place in the 50s,
yes.
A drug addict.
Yes.
How do you prepare for a role like that?
I dig out my grandmother's apron. And for me, as long as I knew what I was there for, and I tried to just go
for
a ride. I was there to leave my husband, and he was there to keep me. And therein lies the conflict.
Yes.
I was done.
But did you want to leave him?
I felt that I had no other choice.
Because it's amazing. I mean, the life that you have to give a character, a lot of people don't understand this. They see the finished product on screen.
Mm-hmm.
But it's the work that you do. It's why this show, when I talk about Salome Jens, I just do the work.
It's sharing. It's sharing a piece of me.
Yes.
It's sharing a slice.
And how do you substitute that? I mean, you're not a drug addict and you didn't live in that area. And you, besides your grandmother's apron.
Yes.
How do you relate to that character?
I go into personal life. I go into substitution. I go into I work very much from what's happening in my life now.
Right.
So what am I done with today? How am I standing up for myself today? How am I taking care of me today?
Mm.
And that's what I try to bring.
And do you work on, if I were this character, how would I play her?
I try to think about, I try to write down everything they say about her and put that into a context of how that relates to me.
Yeah.
And then I just try to give my truth.
Right,
and live.
The truth.
And live.
That's what it really is about.
And not push and not fight and not think it has to be something, just show up, connect, and go for the ride. That's what I like out of it. It's like a dance to me. I love to salsa dance, and I love the same thing. Let's just go for the ride.
Yeah.
You know, the words are the line. You know, the steps are the lines.
Yeah.
You know, now let's fly.
Yes.
Yes.
And when you did Proof.
Yes.
How did you prepare for that?
That is again about trusting. Are you my friend? Do you love me? You know, can I trust my own mind? I mean, you know, she thinks she's going crazy. And you know, doesn't everyone worry about that a little bit somewhere?
You said something there that I know that Mark would stop you and I would stop my students when
okay.
I hear is she.
Is she.
It's I.
It's I. Yes. When I'm doing it, it's I.
Yeah.
I think you have
how
to look at the
character. How important is that? May I ask you how important that is? The difference between I
and she?
Her and she?
I think people perceive she, but I'm bringing I.
That's exactly right. I mean, and so many people forget that, how when I say I, you know, you bring your hand in. When they say she, you go out.
Oh, I love that.
You know?
Sure.
So you're letting it out instead of bringing it in.
Mm.
If I were this character, how would I play it? Because we know what the character can play, but what can Cindy bring to the character?
Mm-hmm.
That's what they want to know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Arthur Penn, a member of the Actors Studio, a wonderful director, and he always told me, break the rules.
Break the rules.
Yes. Which is what Actors Studio did in the beginning. I mean, the group theater did that.
Sure.
You know.
And, you know, from improv, there are basic rules, you know, yes and things like that.
Right,
but
right.
But I was a kid who was always on stage and just had fun doing it, and that's why I did it. And so it wasn't like I came out and went, oh, now I have to learn how to act. To me, it's always just been delving in deeper. How can I make this easier?
Easier. That's easier. A great way to look at it.
Easier.
How do I make this easier?
Yeah. How do I channel the anxiety of, ooh, I'm going to go do this, into the scene? How do I put the gun down, you know, let myself off the hook so that I can be free to share?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, some of the films that we saw, could you tell us a little bit how you worked for some of those?
Sure. Let's see, I was really fortunate to work with Tim Bagley, who is an established actor, and he was fantastic on the set, and he was very helpful. And Lin-Marie Stewart and Sherry Shepherd were in the short. It was called Average Joe, and that was fantastic, and he was really helpful to me. And I think that's important on set, is to have actors take care of each other, right. And he was fantastic with that.
New York is very good on that, on actors supporting each other. Out here, it's
Chicago too.
Yes, I've heard that.
Amazing.
Out here, it's very, there's competition too much here.
Yeah, but I've continued to try to give. If I get into something, I try to bring my friends in. I try to give opportunities. I try to share information, because you hope it comes back to you. You know.
It's true. In New York, we used to do that, send everybody up for the same part, and whoever got it bought the drinks.
I love that.
Whoever got it.
Yeah, sure, absolutely.
And there was no anger. But out here, I find a lot of competition for that way. People resent. They're not at the studio. I mean, the studio is a place where you can go there and fail. That's what you want. You know you can do that there. It's a place where the support is wonderful.
Yes, yeah. I'm looking forward to really jumping in and learning and soaking up everything I can.
Now, did you say your partner got in with you too?
No, neither of my partners did.
Oh, okay. And
yet.
Well, yeah, because
we're both deserving, that's for sure.
Sometimes, it takes a long time to get in.
It took two years for me to go through the process.